Welcome to this Hindenburg Journalist tutorial, where we will be talking about the automated levels. The automated levels are a guideline for setting correct radio broadcast levels. Anytime you import an audio file into the workspace, Hindenburg Journalist will adjust the levels accordingly. Hindenburg detects whether the audio is narration or music. Narration will automatically be set to -9 on a QPPM meter. This is the recommended narration levels for Scandinavian broadcasters.
Simone and Kipski have been creating crazy sounds together since they were kids in the city of Utrecht.
And the automatic levels set the narration to peak at average -9.
That's Simone Ackermans, the Simone of Simone and Kipski.
We can also do the same with this interview clip.
We used to go skateboarding, and then when we got tired, we'd just spend hours pressing pause buttons on cassette decks and trying to make samples, sort of.
All this is done using the future audio measurement tool, Loudness. Hindenburg Journalist follows all R-128 Loudness recommendations from EBU. Loudness is currently being adopted by broadcasters and the audio industry. When we import music into Hindenburg, levels will be set to -23 LUFS. This level fits both current and future broadcast outputs. Since the levels are set by using loudness, all audio will be perceived as equally loud, so mixing is easy. I will now mix this interview with this piece of music. Let me first place the interview clip over the music. Now note the balanced mix between interview and music.
Pressing pause buttons on cassette decks and trying to make samples, sort of. I walked out this morning.
It was like a veil had been removed from before my eyes. The great advantage of using loudness measurements is that you can import any type of music, and the levels will be set so all sounds equally loud. Let's take this piece of classical music. The classical music is set to -1.2 dB, but the pop music is set to -11 dB. This is obviously a huge difference, but since the pop music is compressed and the classical music is not, they will be perceived as being equally loud. We can also take a piece of slightly more modern music. Note that the automation regulates the levels further down than the first piece of pop music. This is because this piece is even more compressed, and more compressed sound is perceived as louder. I mentioned before that Hindenburg Journalist will differentiate between music and narration. And this is because narration needs a little more presence in the mix. Therefore, music is set to -23 LUFS and narration is set to -21 LUFS. These settings are the generic levels in Hindenburg Journalist. In Hindenburg Journalist Pro, it's also possible to set other preferences. Go to Hindenburg Preferences Advanced. And from here, you can choose between the EU mode, the UK mode, and the US mode. Let's try the UK mode. Let's begin by highlighting these regions and perform a manual auto level. Now we can see that the levels are set to the slightly more conservative BBC recommendations. Let's now open the loudness meter, and we can even apply a BBC meter. From the classical music, we can now jump to the pop music. These are the levels for music. Now let's do the same for narration. According to the BBC recommendations, narration should peak at 6 on a BBC meter. Now let's see if that works.
Creating crazy sounds together since they were kids in the city of Utrecht. That's Simone Ackermans, the Simone of Simone and Kipski. Ackermans says the band's music mixes the layered beats popular with his childhood favorites, Public Enemy, with guitars, drums, keyboards, even sitars.
And all this is done without using any compression or normalization, just by setting the correct levels. I hope you found this useful. Thank you for watching.